Next reaction, write down.
So can you draw the like
for this one? We are using CH3OH in this reaction. See, this one. We are using here CH3OH.
So it's only CH3OH or like any other?
No, no, CH3OH. Any nucleophile you can take over.
Okay. But if I, so I can take C2H5OH and all of that.
Now the product is what? If I write down the product in one single step, what we have to do? This OCH3 will come over here.
Wait, sir, this doesn't follow the keto.
Oh, okay, ether. Yeah,
this, this comes over here, and H comes over here onto this carbon. This is the product of this reaction.
Okay.
Alkoxy mercuration demercuration. Mechanism you see? In the first step, what happens? HgOAC. This pi electron will attack onto this and will get a cyclic mercuranium ion. Delta positive, delta positive. In the next step, we have alcohol, not water. So this lone pair. With this lone pair, alcohol behaves as a nucleophile and this will attack onto the more substituted carbon atom, which is this, right? And this bond pair onto this mercury, so the product is CH3CH2OCH3CH2HgOAC. Always it is opposite side attack, okay, opposite of this ring. You will minimize the repulsion, steric repulsion or hindrance. Now in the next step, we have NaBH4 with OH minus. This replaces this group and it forms CH3CHOCH3CH2H. See, overall what happens? Addition of OCH3 and H plus. From where this H plus is coming? Or hydride ion. It is coming from NaBH4. Right? NaBH4. So if you write here NABD4, right, NABD4, then here we'll have D not hydrogen, okay, NABD4, then here we'll have D not hydrogen. So keep this in mind.
So where is the OH minus? So it's in a base.
So in
basic medium reaction. It's not taking part in the reactions.
So it always just takes the H and puts it on that one and
yes,
the negative and puts.
Correct. So basically you have to take care of what you have here, what is the solvent, that is alcohol or water, and here we have H or D or N.
So what if you put like CH3COOH over there, I take CH3COOH,
you'll get then
CH3COOH.
If you have CH3COOH here, any compound which has active hydrogen. Okay. Any compound which has active hydrogen. So this lone pair is behaving as a nucleophile entirely. So this will attack first and then H plus goes on. Yahan pe aisa hoga to CH3OH positive charge. In the next step, this will write what? Minus H plus. This H plus goes out and will get OCH3. So if you have this, then it is O C double bond of CH3.
The mechanism will be similar for any other nucleophile.
Any other nucleophile, it is there, it is possible. Even if you write down ammonia, NH3, for that also it's same.
Okay.
You'll get NH2 in that case. Okay? So this,
yeah,
they'll change this only in the exam.
Okay.
Okay? Next, you write down hydroboration, oxidation reaction.
Yeah. So what happens to HgOAC? Once
this after this, what happens? After this, the mechanism is quite complex. Okay, in the books also it is not given.
Okay.
What they have written, you'll get some complex of mercury. Some book they have written simply Hg and ACOH, acetic acid. And some book they have given, right, we'll get some complex of mercury and this product. You don't have to worry with this.
Complex as in?
Complex compound means mercury with some, you know, complex compound, there are many things. Bonding is complex, structure is very complex. Or complex we also define in terms of whether it can lose its property in the solution or not. So there are many things. Okay. So don't worry with
that. I have an unrelated now. Mm. You know that the cyclohexene is the most stable ring because it's non-planar. But then according to our assignment...
When I said that, cyclohexene...
is more stable than cyclopentane and all
hexane.
That. Hexane. Uh-huh. Is more stable than cyclopentane and...
because of less angular strength.
Yes, sir, because it's non-planar.
Because of less angular strength. It it exists in chair form. Because overall its energy is less in this form. It exists in chair form like this, but it is stable because of less angular strength. These are conformers, like different conformations of cyclohexane. Board, twisted board.
So, but don't those two carbons still have angles?
I mean, all are sp3 only. So,
it's not planar.
See, उसको देखने से क्या लग रहा है? ये angle is lesser than this. But ये है तो ये 3D molecule है, 3D restriction. All carbon atoms are sp3 hybridized.
Yes.
So bond angle to be 120.
So it's actually 100.
For tetrahedron.
No, so
even though in chair.
Yeah, it is. Bond angle to be 100. Bond angle to be according to the geometry. But overall, since the molecule is in two different planes, right? Overall, the energy of this is least among the different conformations of cyclohexane. That's why this is most stable.
So
twisted board we have, board form we have.
Those two vertices also have 109 degrees.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
We'll discuss this. We haven't done this, right? Okay, next write down hydroboration oxidation reaction.
Then
so organic chemistry, if you look at the question, abhi tumko ketone ka reaction dikhega. Steril ketone. That's why it's very important in organic chemistry. Once you finish, you have to do it again. Dobar karna padega organic chemistry. There are some reactions which we are studying here, but detailed mechanism, everything you'll understand in the other chapters like aldehyde, ketone. Carbene, there are many reactions which forms carbene as an intermediate, like. Aromatic chemistry का बहुत सारा example है जहाँ carbene intermediate form करता है। अब अभी मैं अगर वो कराऊँगा तो carbene कहाँ पढ़ाया है? नहीं पढ़ाया। Right, so we'll go धीरे से, ठीक है? धीरे जाएंगे।
So we'll start 12th. Can we just keep doing hydrocarbon with the?
I will do organic only. Like after this, we'll do some GOC तो कर चुके हैं ना?
Yes.
Reaction mechanism करेंगे। There in that chapter we'll do almost 80% or 70% of chemical reactions of all chapters.
Shouldn't we have done reaction mechanism before?
First step. Reaction mechanism at least we should do after nomenclature, and then isomerism, and then hydrocarbon. Yeah, but here the problem is we have to follow the school the pattern also. Otherwise, some of you will say, sir, school mein diye ho raha hai, yahan par ye ho raha hai. Coaching industry mein, they'll teach first nomenclature and then they'll go to the reaction mechanism, GOC. Uske baad aate hain wo log isomerism pe. Isomerism, you remember tautomerism ka concept hai? Tautomerism requires what? Resonance. Uske pehle you have to understand resonance. So GOC, reaction mechanism, then baaki sab kuch. ठीक है, but we'll do. अभी हम we have time, we'll do. Next write down hydroboration oxidation reaction. Write down. This reaction involves addition of borane to an alkene. What is the formula of borane? BH3. Diborane is B2H6, the dimer of borane, right?
So which reaction was this?
Hydroboration oxidation reaction. This reaction involves addition of borane to an alkene, which forms organoborane intermediate. Organoborane, ये सब term है, इसको tension नहीं लेना, ठीक है? Just ignore it. लिखने के लिए लिख रहे हैं. Organoborane intermediate. Organoborane intermediates are this. So general term, RBH2. Don't write this. RBH2, R2BH, and then R3BH. So eventually you get trialkyl borane in this reaction first, in the first system. Okay? Next line down. R3B, sorry. R3B. Trialkyl borane. Next line down. In the next step, trialkyl borane is allowed to react with H2O2, hydrogen peroxide, in basic medium, OH minus. H2O2, OH minus.
So,
trialkyl borane is allowed to react with hydrogen peroxide, H2O2, in basic medium, and forms alcohol. This reaction follows anti-Markovnikov addition. Anti-Markovnikov addition. See, in the first one also we get alcohol. Here also we are getting alcohol. But the first one is what? Markovnikov. This one is anti-Markovnikov. Okay? You see, the alkene is suppose CH2, double bond CH2. This is alkene. And what are the reactants for this? Reagent for this? The first one is, we use BH3. In ether, basically solvent we use, and we can also have THF, tetrahydrofuran, which is a cyclic ether. What is the structure of THF? THF plus structure here. Tetrahydrofuran. Okay.
Isn't that just
furan?
Huh? Isn't that
tetrahydrofuran?
I thought it's just called
furan. Furan has two
W's. First is this, and in the second step, it is allowed to react with H2O2 with OH minus. H2O2 with OH minus. Okay. So the product in this reaction is CH3CH2OH plus BOH whole price, orthobotic acid. Okay, this is the product. How do we write down the product? Anti-Markovnikov addition of H plus and OH minus. Okay? Now how the reaction proceeds? See, BH3, all three boron hydrogen bonds are reactive. Right? All three boron hydrogen bonds. So what happens here? This converts into CH3, CH2, BH2 in the first step. H minus, this comes over here, take this H minus, and then this boron attached with this carbon atom. This comes over here, it takes this H minus, and then this boron carbon attached. So basically, CH3, CH2, BH2. You see, this is this one, RBH2, where R is this group. Okay? If we allow this to react with CH2 double bond CH2 again, what is the next one we'll get? Actually, in this reaction, we are taking 3 moles of this alkene. Overall.
So you have to just keep BH this.
Yes,
twice.
3 moles of this, and we'll get 3 moles of alcohol. I forgot to write this, but this is a reaction. 3 moles of this and this. So again, if you have this alkene, 1 mole we have used here, another mole is this. So this again replaces the hydrogen. Right, so we'll get what? CH3, CH2, whole twice, BH, and then one more step, CH2 double bond CH2 gives you CH3, CH2, whole thrice B. That is R3B, right? Trialkyl borane. Write down the name. R3B, trialkyl borane.
Wait, so Sudhir. So the electrons, if they shift from the double bond to carbon and then from carbon to hydrogen.
Yes.
How does that happen? So like the hydrogen will have to come and pick it up and then it will leave again. So how does it sound?
See, one possibility is this. Another way also you can understand that this boron is electron deficient. Okay? It will electron accept it, it has one vacant p orbit. Another way also, this is also one type of mechanism they have given in the book. Another way also what they define, that this comes over here onto this carbon atom. And this electron pair is taken up by this boron. And one H plus comes out which attached with this carbon atom. That way also you can understand. Electron pair accepts, behaves as a Lewis acid, then this H gets attached with this carbon atom, you get this one. Both ways. Okay? This is trialkyl borate. Now this trialkyl borate on reaction with H2O2OH-. We do not have mechanism here. H2O2OH-, it gives CH3, CH2OH, three molecules of this, plus BOH.
So over here you said the electron pair jumps onto that carbon. So this carbon becomes positive, that one becomes negative.
Alright. CH2 double bond CH2. And we have TH3.
Yeah.
This comes over here and this attacks onto this positive charge.
Yeah.
So this is CH2. Positive CH2B negative. Okay. Now one of the hydrogen takes this bond pair, comes out with H minus, and this attachment works.
So hydrogens also do that. They also take electrons with them.
No, it actually. No, it takes this H plus. This takes this H plus from this molecule.
Okay.
This goes over here. This is an electron pair that takes H plus from this.
Okay, and then
so makes this for a negative charge
goes and attacks the positive. Yeah. So does H2O2 dissociate to become OHOH?
H2O2 is in peroxy acid. H2O2 is an acid, peroxy acid. The structure is open book structure. This is the structure. So usually this also bond length. But it is an acid, right? So it this H plus is taken up by this OH minus. And then H2O and then H2O.
So will it under any condition become
OH? OH radical it may form. This homolysis is possible. Homolysis is possible. Radical may form. Because peroxy acids are generally very weak of peroxy bond because of the presence of lone pair. We have lone pair repulsion here. That's why the bond is very weak. Okay, so here it is anti Markovnikov addition. First one it was Markovnikov addition. Okay, this is in this one it does not make any sense, but if you have unsymmetrical alkene, then it is.